Yo, YouTube. Yeah, man, it's 7 American, and welcome to episode 1 of my Shao Kahn guide. In this video, I'm just going to be showing you guys his new tools, his footsies, and his pressure. So I'm just going to break things down and give you guys a bit more of a, you know, a touch of how to use Shao Kahn. And in the next episode, I'm going to be touching on other areas of Shao Kahn's play style. So further ado, I'm just going to take it away. Let's go. Right, let me start off with what Shao Kahn players do wrong when it comes to pressure. So I see a lot of Shao Kahn players use the forward 3-4 string, trying to force opponents to respect them and try mix them the best way possible. Listen, knock that shit off. That's all I'm going to tell you right now. Knock that shit off. You are not supposed to extend the string all the time. You know, the 4-3 alone is a 10 starter minus 8 on block. And I see a lot of players out there that go on social media and say, oh yeah, but it's got a big gap. It's so easy to flawless. Blah, 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 blah. Just because it has a gap doesn't mean the string is trash. If moves have gaps, that basically means you have mind games towards it. So you can just dish out the standard 4-3 and players will be expecting the 4-4 to flawless block it. But you can just use the 4-3 and just grab your opponent 4-3 and just block, see if they can be able to commit. That's the whole part of neutrals. And I see a lot of Shao Kahn players just blowing out the whole string and not trying to play mind games with it. They're just trying to see if they can be able to gamble their way into victory instead of trying to stick to their neutrals and ground game. Knock that shit off and stop playing the victim. So let's get to business and start talking about some real Shao Kahn stuff. So his standard one is a 9 starter plus 4 normal. So it's probably one of the most important normals out of his whole moveset. And I'm talking about strings and specials included. This is mandatory for Shao Kahn because it opens a lot of doors when it comes to, you know, when you throw that standard one, you can be able to throw loop your opponent. So your opponent has to guess, now or never shall I down two. Whereas you can either throw the standard one or just go for the standard 4-3 or just test your waters and just move back, see if they can be able to just blow a string and you can be able to whiff punish, or you can just go move back or just use a low. You have the upper hand when you're using that standard one. So the more you use it and it lands on block, the more opportunities and more comfort and breathing room you have to be creative with your normals and your strings. This is the move everyone should be using all the time instead of this 4-3-4, 4-3-4, 4-3-4 nonsense. You're supposed to be landing that standard one, trying to plan evil schemes in your head and what you can be able to do in your opponents. You're just going to throw the standard one, try and move back a little bit, see if they're going to try claim their turn and mash out of the plus 4. Or you're just going to go and throw them, or you can just use the 4-3 if you think they're very hefty and you understand how they play as an opponent. You can plan so many evil schemes with that standard one. And I understand that there's whiff issues with Shao Kahn with certain amount of characters, but a lot of male characters are having this issue as well. I want to talk about his down 3 now, which is a 9 startup minus 5 on block normal. It has a lot of stagger, push back, and a little bit more control that you can be able to claim your turn back. You can be able to use it for external footsies and also as well just for bait. So you can be able to just dish in the down 3, move back, dish in the down 3, down 4 after, and try claim your turn back just to outfootsie your opponent. It brings a lot of mind games when it comes to the low profiling game and keeps him in a neutral state because he's got really good recovery from the normal. So make sure you, when you're using the down 3 and using the down 4, just be careful because, you know, the more you use it, the more your opponent's going to try jump and expect the down 4 afterwards. So don't forget it's minus 5 on block, so they do have an opportunity to maneuver around, and that's where you can be able to anti-air your opponents when you expect that. The next move I want to talk about is Shao Kahn's heel kick, which is a 28 startup plus 6 normal. I would recommend high players using this as a shimmy and a Oki go-to move. And also as well, if you've got access to mid-screen and your opponent doesn't expect you're gonna dish out that heel kick, that's when I would recommend, you know, just throwing it out there just for additional pressure, just to force your players to respect you a bit with the plus frame. So yeah, it's I can't really recommend a lot of players out there that don't even know how to tap into wave dash, shimmy, have good, that doesn't have, like, you know, clean movement in general, this normal, because it's very easy to flawless block this if you're very predictable. So you gotta shimmy with it, you gotta make sure you have good spacing with this before you dish it out. You gotta dish it out when your opponent least expects it. Yeah man, the down four, this used to be my main squeeze back before the patch. I usually just use the down four into standard one, as it used to be -7 on block, but I've nerfed the poking system, so the meta is more focused on using just a standard, you know, low profile mid or low profile low into strings instead of just mashing pokes all day, which is good news. It's a good news. It makes it a little bit more of a clean diversity towards the game, but it kind of affected Shao Kahn in the process. So the move is very viable still, but you just have to be a bit more respectful. So these three are your pressure strings. This is something you should be using when you want to fight the good fight back. So say like Night Wolf is all up in your face, Johnny Cage is all up in your face, the Joker's up all up in your face, and you want to fight back, you want to scrap back. So you got the standard 1-2, which is -7 on block. You got the 1-2 into finisher, which is -5 on block, and you got the 1-4, which is -3 on block. So the 1-2 into finisher has a flawless block, so you have to be careful when you're dishing it out. So mix that up a bit, man. And the way you should be using these strings is set up your standard one, set up your standard one, or set up your standard three. And if you're confident, use those strings afterwards. So the idea is to use your normals first and then lead it onto the strings afterwards for additional pressure and a bit more control and respect. So I'm just gonna leave it to this. Go in the training room, install all of these normals and these strings in your brain, put your opponent on block, start shadow boxing, trying to get more of an understanding on how to, you know, use Shao Kahn's neutrals a bit more better, and, you know, pressure and ground game. And yeah man, and I'm just going to show some gameplay footage online of me using the stuff that we've been talking about. So I'm just going to roll the clip, and make sure you drop a sub and a like, man. Don't miss out on episode 2. I got a lot of things to explain on that episode, and I've got some more Mortal Kombat videos on the way as well. So yeah man, drop a sub, drop a like, let's get things moving. Peace.